I recently did a video on a very amazing gene, the NRF2, which is like a gene that protects you against disease and especially cancer. And I found some additional interesting data on this that I want to share with you. But if you haven't seen the first video, watch that first. I'm going to put a link down below of exactly what it does. But this gene is like the master gene that activates hundreds of other genes that protect your cells. And these other genes are related to antioxidants because your body has networks of antioxidants. So antioxidants don't just come from external sources from your food. Your body makes them, so they come from within. And the term for that is endogenous. So this gene regulates endogenous antioxidants as well as the detoxification genes, which helps break down things that cause cancer, like chemicals in the environment. We call those carcinogens. So this gene protects against trauma, emotional stress, pollution, toxins, UV radiation, and also the free radical damage that comes from having nutritional deficiencies. So it's a very, very important gene. In the other video, I talked about people having an overexpression of this gene. And these are the type of people that pretty much can eat what they want, smoke every day, drink, and live to be 99 years old, right? Yet everyone else has a normal expression of this gene, which makes them prone to develop diseases and cancer. So the question is, what can you do about it? There's something called epigenetics, which means above genetics. So what I want to talk about is some of the things that you can do on an epigenetic level to get an advantage of having more expression of this gene. Now, again, this gene acts as a switch that tells the cell that oxidative damage is occurring, and then it turns on the body's defense mechanisms by activating genes that help the cell produce protective antioxidant molecules. So here are the pro NRF2 compounds. Number one, curcumin from turmeric. Number two, sulforaphane from cruciferous vegetables, of course. Number three, quercetin from onions, green tea. And there's quite a few other vegetables that have this compound present as well. And number four, a phytonutrient called fistin, which is in strawberries, onions, cucumbers. And there are two other things that are not going to be a big surprise, but regular mild to moderate exercise will enhance the expression of this gene. And this is definitely no surprise, but fasting can increase the expression of this gene by 1.5 to 5 times the normal expression. So I think out of all the things you can really do, man, fasting, hands down, is probably the most important thing to focus on. So if you're new to my channel and you want more information, click the link down below and start doing intermittent fasting on a regular basis. Hey, before you go, if you're benefiting from any of my content, I would love to hear about your success story. Please share it in the link down below.